It came from.
All right. So this next one here, this is what do you do when you're stuck on a problem? This is by Caters on the the user experience subreddit. They go on to write, currently stuck on a problem that I can't solve properly. I'm curious to hear what's your approach when you find yourself in those situations. Do you reframe the problem in a different way? Do you have a specific set of questions that you always ask yourself or any other systems that you follow? Really curious to know about this. Thanks. Blake, what do you do when you're stuck on a problem?
So I've learned the hard way to do this. And I think it sounds obvious, but sometimes it is not the most straightforward thing to do. Go ask for help, because you can ruminate on a problem, apply your specific framework or systems thinking to it, and you still may not be coming at it the correct way. And expertise, or just sometimes bouncing ideas off of somebody else within your team or like within the company you work for who has a diverse set of experience outside of your own current experience, could really change how you're looking at a problem to help you figure out if you do need to reframe it. Do you need to take a step back and do more research before you actually define what the problem is? But there's a reason that even when I did contracting on my own, like as a freelancer, this is where the podcast studio was at one point, and it was a startup incubator. I would go to the developer that worked outside my office and ask him questions about something I was tackling, and him not even, you know, being a part of, you know, my little contracting thing that I was doing, it still was helpful to like talk through ideas and get concepts down. So in my case, when I get stuck on a problem, I've gotten to the point where I make myself ask for help, either with somebody I'm super comfortable with, like a mentor, or one of my teammates that I'm currently working with.
That's some great advice, Blake. I actually, it might even sound simpler than that, but what I do, the very first thing when I encounter a brick wall, the first thing I do is I step away and I don't work. And I typically find that when I come back to a problem with fresh eyes, it's a little bit better. I think asking for help is a great, great solution. You know, there are benefits. Like here's another, ties into our last question, design agency. Human factors company, you're working with a bunch of people who have a variety of experiences with human factors. And so they can come back to you and say, hey, here's XYZ, you know, different solutions that you could employ for that product. But I think when you're stuck on a problem, the best thing for me to do is I step back and I say, okay, I let my team know, hey, I am stepping back for a couple hours. I've hit a wall. And here's my problem. I let them know. And I'm just stepping back. If you need me, I'm here, but I'm stepping back. And I'll step back and I'll think about it for a couple hours. I'll go do something else. I'll switch modes, which is often helpful. And what I often find myself doing is when I try to switch modes is I fixate on the thing. And I don't know if that's helpful, but sometimes fixating on the problem while you're doing something else, like playing a game or watching TV or something, and it just drives into your brain. And it's like, oh, there it is. That's at least my next steps. I try to not necessarily solve the problem, but identify what the next steps are. Do I ask for help? Do I do a competitive analysis with other things that are trying to do the same thing? Do I research X, Y, and Z to try to solve the problem? Do I need to talk to a user about the thing that I'm trying to solve? Like, so I think about the next steps necessarily and not necessarily the solution. And I find that when I come back to work, when I sit down, I go, okay, I at least know what I need to do next. And then I do it. So that's kind of what I do when I'm stuck on a problem. I know it's easier to say step away. Not everybody can, especially if you work in an office with other people that depend on your schedule. Make yourself available. And I know it's not necessarily always easy to step away in an office environment where you're expected to work. But if you are working from home and have that flexibility, that helps. So anyway, well, why don't we, anything else to add to that one, Blake?
I do have one more tidbit for it, because you did drive a good thing home. And like a strategy that I use probably once a week, because I get hung up on development issues, is if I just really hit a wall, I can't do anything else, because of the benefits of working from home, I will step away and do as hard of a workout as I can and sleep on the problem. And one example of that is it happened to me this week. it happened to me basically yesterday. Did the workout, went to sleep. I woke up about like 5:45 this morning and had a random idea that just came to me. So it was one of those things that, like you said, stepping away from the problem and letting it ruminate in the back of your mind, because I go to bed thinking about problems that I've had during the day and trying to solve them, and probably am still doing so subconsciously while asleep. But sometimes it just provides you a different perspective when you wake up the next day and you can try something new. So that's another strategy you can try and take.